Well, you don't need a ticket, but you will need a reservation to use any of the pools in the city of Syracuse that will be open this summer. To talk more about it, we're joined live by City Parks Commissioner Julie Lefebvre. Julie, thanks so much for joining us tonight. Appreciate it.
Absolutely. It's for a great reason.
Absolutely. Perfect timing, right, with the forecast. I'm sure you heard it. It's going to be hot over the next several days. Struggle to get here to this point. We've only going to have two pools open starting tomorrow because of funding issues. How worried were you as we got closer and closer to the start of summer that we were going to go a summer with no city pools open?
I don't know that a day went by that myself and my staff didn't talk about it. What kind of summer would we have if we didn't open the pool? So the worry increased with every passing day.
Well, at least no more worries. You got at least two that are going to be opening up tomorrow. That's Kirk Park Pool and Schiller Park Pool. Then Onondaga and Thorndon, they open on Thursday, July 23rd, thanks to some generous people around the community raising money for that. How's this all going to work? Because you can't just show up and go in, right? So how's this all going to work?
Exactly. So our lifeguard staff have been working around the clock right now. Sorry, there's a train coming. I've been working around the clock right now and comparing all the trends nationwide. So what we've come up with is that we can only take up the crowds of 50 at one time. Reservations are required. Of course, there's no charge for that. But upon entry, you know, we will take a temperature. We will look for the we will have to take the contact information. But once people get in the door and we'll let them in as soon as we can, they can swim for up to 40 minutes. And then in between the next hour, the next reservation, we will be thoroughly sanitizing anywhere that any of our patrons went.
So I got a couple of follow-ups here. So first off, how do I actually get a reservation? Where do I go? How do I do that? How much in advance do I have to do that? Can I do it that morning of?
So we take them up to 2 days in advance. So right now you could reserve for Friday. Yesterday we started taking reservations for tomorrow. You can do them same day. You could call from the parking lot, but it is phone only. And it's only from 11 a.m. to 6 a.m. or 6 p.m. that we will answer the phone. You just have to tell us how many are in your party or in within your household, and you all just show up at the same time, and we'll let you in the door once you bring your mask, get your temperature check, and give us the contact information.
But you said 40 minutes is all you're going to get in there. Who's going to be pulling people out of there? Because on a hot day, I can't imagine anybody's going to want to get up out of a pool and leave. So how do we turn this thing over?
So, you know, it's a great question, and what I've told my staff is very much this is a trial and error, not trial and error, but, you know, we'll go our first week, and if we're not filling every 40-minute time slot, maybe we'll do 2 hours next week. We're very much going to be fluid as we go through the summer so that we can accommodate the most people in the fairest way possible.
So up to, I think you said it was up to 50 go in for 40 minutes, and then that 50 leave, and then you disinfect. Is that how it works?
Yes. Yes. So that's following CDC recommendations.
Yeah, I think you mentioned it a little bit, but what does that disinfecting actually, what's that going to look like?
So we're going to disinfect anywhere that our patients went. So within the locker room, it's going to be, you know, it's the approved solution right now that, you know, kills the COVID virus. So it would be the handles getting out of the ladders. It would be the fencing. It would be anything that anybody touched.
Obviously, there are other things in your department besides just pools. Those are the ones in a hot summer day people want. But, you know, city parks, how are they looking? You know, can we do tennis, basketball, play areas? Are those things open? What are the policies there? What can people do if they can't get into a pool?
Well, it's important to remember that we have a lot of spray features, too.
True.
So you're not going to go for the sports. We have close to a dozen spray features in our city parks, and that you can go any time of day at sunrise to sunset. But as far as other sports, you know, you can walk. We have walking paths, soccer. Some of the sports are allowed right now in just like a drill type mode. Basketball, unfortunately, you know, I know that's a hot one that everybody wants, but, you know, it's just such a close, it's a high risk sport, much like football would be. So we have to wait for guidance from the state before we can do that. But soccer's allowed, tennis is allowed, all the courts are open. We encourage people to use our parks for any way that they want to safely recreate.
Where are, actually, I forgot just for a moment there about some of those spray areas. Are those at many of the parks and kind of what other spray pads, things like that? I mean, places to cool off if you can't get into the pool, right?
So I would encourage anybody, because there is close to a dozen, always follow our Facebook page, because anytime we have a hot day coming, we list them all. But some of them are at the same place where the pool is. So Thorndon Park has a spray feature. Schiller does. So when you get kicked out, if you don't want to leave, you know, you're still hot, you can just walk right next door or right outside the fence and cool off there. But they are spread across the city, not just in one area.
Beautiful. Julie Lefebvre, I can't thank you enough for coming on tonight and talking to us about the pools and the parks and things like that. And best of luck tomorrow. And then when you get to open those two additional parks
yeah.
in about a week or so, that's going to be a lot of fun, too. So thanks for joining us
tonight. It's all thanks to the community. So thank you.
Right.